Today I'm going to talk about how to enable advanced plotting directly out of ADS using the ADS data link to Python. You can use this capability even if you know nothing about Python, but you will still need to complete the setup steps which I described in an earlier short video. Once the data link is set up, the examples that I'm going to show today will just work. There are also several other reference videos which give more details about the ADS data link. You can find more information about the basics here, and also learn how to connect measurement equipment to ADS using the data link here. I'll make the workspace that I'm going to show today available to download for free. To get it, click the link below the video and log on to the Keysight Knowledge Center. It's easy to register for free access. This video is geared towards ADS users who want to make 3D plots, so first I will cover the steps to enable this in ADS without getting into Python. If you don't know anything about Python, that's fine. The data link operates behind the scenes for these examples. At the end, I'll talk about how to develop your own Python plotting scripts, and of course, all the Python scripts I'll show are included in the ADS workspace, so you can view and modify them if you'd like. But again, if all you want to do is make 3D plots from ADS, you don't need to know about Python. I've already completed the data link setup, and I have my workspace open, so I'll start by going to the first schematic, Simple 3D. This is just an S-parameter simulation of a transistor. Normally I'd look at gain versus frequency, but in this case I want to see how the gain changes with drain voltage bias too. So I'll do a simple parameter sweep of the drain voltage on top of the S-parameter simulation, which already sweeps frequency, and I'll run the simulation. Now in the data display, you can see that S21 has two dependencies, VDD and frequency. Since there are two dependencies, it's possible to generate a 3D plot by simply enabling this equation in ADS. Then a separate window pops up with the surface plot, and it's interactive. I can rotate it around or I can zoom in. So let's examine this ADS function that I used to generate the plot. The plot's generated using a Python script I wrote called surface_3d.py, and the data transfer is facilitated by the function call Python script IO. It's pretty simple. A swept variable with at least two dependencies can be passed into Python, and then Python generates a surface plot. At the end, some information is also sent back to ADS, just a few strings, or perhaps an error message if something goes wrong. Best part is, any swept ADS variable with at least two dependencies can automatically be 3D plotted from ADS with this function. You don't even need to touch Python. So for example, here are some DCIV curves for this transistor. I swept the gate and drain voltages, then of course the output current has two dependencies. Well, I'll just put the output current variable right into the same ADS equation I just used, and here is a 3D plot of the transistor's IV curve. I've also set up the function to take some optional user inputs for plot labels and configuration parameters. For the labels, just enter an array of strings inside a bracket as title and then X, Y, and Z. So my title will be 3D IV curves, then maybe X will be VG, and Y is VD, and Z is ID. And there are the labels on the plot. As far as plot configuration, I can pass in grid points, elevation, and azimuth specifications, also in brackets. So let me briefly explain what all these mean. Let's start with grid points. Basically, the Python function interpolates the ADS data to arrive at a usable surface plot. So the grid points parameter sets the number of interpolated points. Having more interpolated points makes a more precise surface, but it takes a little bit longer to process. Elevation and azimuth are just rotation parameters. If I change these, the plot will be rotated differently to start. I've got another Python script which scatterplots the data instead of surface plotting it. To get that, all you need to do is change the Python function from surface3d to scatter3d. So in other words, the data link passes the ADS data through a different Python function, which just plots the input points on a 3D axis. One thing that would be pretty useful is a marker. The beauty of Python is that if you want something, someone has probably already written it, and for markers on graphs, many people have created packages to do this. One that I like is called MPL Data Cursor, and you can install that by bringing up a command prompt and typing pip install MPL Data Cursor. Now, if I reevaluate the equation, I get an interactive cursor on the data. I should mention that my function is written to work specifically with MPL Data Cursor. If you want to use another cursor, you will need to modify the Python scripts. What if I add another dimension? So for example, I'll go back to that S-parameter simulation and now I'll sweep the gate voltage too. When I do that, S21 has three dependencies, VGG, VDD, and frequency. A typical way to deal with this in ADS is to create a slider to specify one sweep point and then do a plot at that point. For example, I made a slider for gate voltage here. Now at each gate voltage, I can generate a 3D plot. This normally works well with ADS plots, but in this case, once the 3D plot pops up, I can't access the data display to move the slider because the Python script is still running and it hasn't returned back yet. This is a problem. Well, one thing that I like about Python is that there are so many ways to do something that when you hit an issue like this, you can get creative. Here's my solution. Instead of plotting 3D data, I just saved an image of the 3D plot to a file. I modified my script to do that, and I saved it under the name surface3dpng. When I run that script, there's no pop-up plot. Instead, there's a new file in the directory called userplot.png, and this is a picture of the 3D plot. I'll just view the image in a standard picture viewer, and then when I move the slider in ADS to change the gate voltage, the picture updates automatically. So I've shown a few simple steps to generate 3D plots using the ADS data link. No Python programming necessary. This is, of course, just the tip of the iceberg. There are all kinds of plots you can make using Python with just a little bit of effort. My background is in power amplifier design, and one thing PA designers do a lot is load pull. To load pull a transistor, you sweep real and imaginary load impedance and then record the power and efficiency delivered. From there, it's possible to plot contour circles of constant efficiency on the impedance plane. Designers have been doing this for years. Really, this is a way of superimposing a 3D plot into 2D. It's kind of like when you make elevation contours on a map to represent a mountain. In this example, using a Python script, I'm able to plot both the 3D mountain and the 2D contour on the same graph. Now, after that, I went a step further. I extended these flat 2D load pull contours to a 3D space, and doing that allows me to effectively represent four dimensions on a 3D plot. In other words, I swept real and imaginary load impedance and also frequency, so efficiency depends on three parameters. To visualize this, I plotted constant efficiency contours on the XY plane and repeated this across frequency, so it's a three-dimensional contour plot. Now, this may seem complicated, but you might be surprised at how straightforward it is to accomplish this in Python. The truth is, developing this type of Python script is something any engineer can do. To build the script, I just followed the procedure outlined in the Datalink Basics video, and I took things one step at a time. First, I sent my data from ADS over to Python using sendDataToPython. Then I brought the ADS data into Python and built the rest of the Python script around that data. To do the surface plot, for example, I had to figure out how to get the input into the right format. I learned to create a uniform XY grid and then interpolate the dependent Z data onto that grid. Once I had the data in the right format, I used matplotlib, which is a library that comes with Anaconda, to create the actual 3D plot. Then I sent a message back to ADS and closed the data link. It wasn't that difficult. Now, ADS can run this script and manage the data transfer. ADS passes data in, runs the script, and gets data back. It's really straightforward to build a Python script that works with the ADS data using the data link. So download the workspace and you can make a quick surface plot or even an advanced plot of something much more complicated. It's all possible to do. Thanks for watching.